Can you understand that? And we become the Christ. The I must die for the we to be born. Right? The good man has to die so the true man can be birthed. Jesus dies, Christ rises. The individual self is not the bad self, just the incomplete self, not the true self. It's inadequate, needy, small, right? The individual self is needy and small and symbolized by the human body of Jesus, and that's why the human body of Jesus had to go so you can get the corporate body. We are the body of Christ. The human body of Jesus had to go, and then Scripture tells us, says, no man after the flesh. Even Jesus Christ, he says, don't know him after the flesh. That fleshly body had to go so there can be the corporate body, the true body of Christ, which is the we. All right, in closing, scapegoat. Yeah, you can read that on your own. Good. Now, thanks for the laughter. We'll leave it just at that. All right. What else is there to say? Let's see. Jesus allowed himself to be transformed from the individual to the corporate through suffering and death. That's how he did it. Jesus took away the sin of the world by exposing it, first of all, as different than we ever imagined. Sin is not what we have ever imagined. He took away the sin of the world by exposing it for what it really is. It's not what we imagined. We thought sin was stealing and lying and things like that. So we tried with all of our willpower to stop stealing and lying and cheating, and that's not sin. That's not sin. Those are the results of sin. You know, sin is separation. It's separation from God and others. You know the power. I can't go on and on. I'm going to read that last line. But even, you know, the symbolism of the cross is primarily the symbolism of forgiveness, right? The only way you ever relieve this world and yourself of evil and sin is through forgiveness. That's the only way of doing it. Forgiveness. What does forgiveness do? Forgiveness causes you to see three graces, I would say. The first grace is, in order for you to forgive, first of all, you have to see the goodness of God. You have to see that God wants forgiveness, that God loves you enough to forgive you and everybody else around you. You must see the goodness of God, forgiveness to first happen. But then you must see a certain goodness in a person for that person to receive forgiveness. There must be the grace to see. You must have the grace to see that, first of all, God is good enough to forgive. Sometimes that's a big one. But then you must have the grace to see that there's goodness in a person who's actually worthy of forgiveness. Like they did a bunch of evil deeds, but down deep inside they are good. The center of a person is good, not evil. You have to see that. And if you don't see that, you won't forgive. And let's take it to the fullest extremes. Let's take a Hitler. If you don't see that at the core of Hitler, there's a goodness in him, you'll never forgive him. But then if you don't see the goodness in him, then you're the ones who set the term. And you decide who has goodness and who doesn't. Well, who makes you the judge and jury? Then you're the one who decides who's good and who's not good based upon what you see, feel, and experience. Well, excuse me. Then we're all damned. If you're going to judge who's good and not good based upon your experience, we're all damned. Forgiveness will never happen. The only cure for evil and sin is forgiveness. It's the only cure. That's why Jesus did it that way. There's only one cure to evil. By forgiving it. And he didn't do this from a distance. First, he experienced all the hell, the worst hell anyone will ever experience. You want to talk about rejection, abandonment, murder? He experienced it all. He said, what's the answer? I'm going to send to hell those who did this to me? No. What did he say? Forgiven. God can see the goodness. One day you'll see what God sees. One day you'll see as God sees. You'll see the goodness in an individual, and then you'll forgive them. The third grace, which I think is beautiful, you must see the goodness in yourself, because it takes a certain divine goodness in you that allows you and enable you to forgive that wretch of a person. Amen. Hope through it all. Like I said, the details are not important. I believe that God is changing the way we think and see. Praise the Lord. That's a good amen. Why don't you stand? Thank you for your patience. Praise God. I expect you to read those notes. I know you will, Eddie. That's good. All right, let us pray. Thank you for the night, Father. You are so willing to teach us. I pray that you would make us more willing to be taught. To stop, pray, contemplate, gaze upon, learn, understand. May we be your students, your disciples. May we both together, teacher and student, experience the fullness of that joy. Let it be in the precious name of Jesus we pray. Everybody says,
Amen.
God bless you. Thanks.
Jesus is called.